San Diego is a beautiful place to live, but not an easy place to fight fires.
Here to share how our terrain actually does play a role here is Pat Abbott. He is Professor Emeritus of Geology, San Diego State University. Mr. Pat Abbott, good to see you as always.
Good to see you.
Let's talk terrain. We've seen these firefighters having to hike up these hills and how difficult it is to fight the fires given the circumstances. How much of a factor does the terrain play in these wildfires?
Well, a tremendous amount.
Yeah.
Even before the fire, first off, it's our microclimate, so we have different vegetation types and different areas of the photography. And then once the topography is there, of course, it causes wind turbulence. On the positive side, that wind turbulence means we now have tornadoes develop around here. Mm. But on the other hand, it also makes fires almost impossible to fight by firefighters on the ground in many of these areas. These hillsides, as a geologist, I can't tell you how many times trying to walk up a hillside, you can't even walk through that chaparral because it's so dense.
Right.
Well, how can a firefighter fight it then? When you need to move fast, only way you can do it is helicopters, airplanes, attack some of these things using our technology.
Yeah. And you want to attack from the air, but then we get the Santa Ana winds and conditions where they're not able to do that even from the air.
What it was particularly stunning this time with that Pacific Palisades fire, that mountain wave wind, where the wind comes at exactly perpendicular to the Santa Monica Mountains and spills over the edge, kind of like a rock in the middle of the river. You know how the water builds up against one side, then on the downstream side, it's just all chaotic.
Yeah.
And the winds
were... It's like whitewater rafting almost when the waves are crashing in those rivers. It's that kind of effect, but it's wind and it's not as visible until you get those flames.
Exactly, and also then impossible to put an aircraft into the air because the air is overwhelmingly turbulent.
Can you believe the feeling of those firefighters when that happened in Palisades and they could not fly? And they knew that that's the only way to put out these flames. It must have been just the most helpless feeling. I mean, I don't think I've heard of mountain waves until
Well, and of course, that's the point here. Some of this terrain, given that vegetation, gives us conditions that are totally impossible to fight the fire. Which also means it's probably time as a society to stop and rethink how we prepare for fires. My textbook that I write, I have a section called Fuels for Fire, and there's a section on trees, shrubs, and grasses. I've added a fourth category of fuel for fires, houses. We build houses out of wood. We bring fill them with wood furniture. In other words, we're basically setting things up for a huge bonfire. And when you see a fire go through an area, the trees have stopped burning, but the houses still are burning.
Wow.
We need a rethink, a way to, I admire the spirit of let's build it back fast, but let's bring in more fire-resistant materials.
How are you gonna build it back?
We talk about these miracle houses that survived the fire.
Yep.
How were they built? We need to accommodate more because we can't stop these fires, so we need to learn how to live with them.
We just had Cal Fire on a few moments ago. I don't know if you caught the interview before you, but we were talking about some of the most dangerous areas, areas of concern in San Diego County. So you lay out a map and you look at all of San Diego, where are the areas that are of most concern?
Well, basically the entire area, if I take a big overview of it, as we've just seen here, once the winds really get going, we've saw it go through Pacific Palisades, through Altadena, areas where you wouldn't have thought that would happen.
Altadena,
If we go back to 2003, our Cedar Fire, that was advancing down, it was moving towards the coast, it had crossed I-15 onto Miramar, and then the winds shifted. In other words, that had the potential to go all the way to the coast, as we do here. Santa Monica Mountains and Malibu are closer to the coast, but what stopped that fire? The ocean. And that's the same kind of potential we have here.
Oh boy. I want to talk more about how to live better in wildfire terrain. And you mentioned, you know, build the houses better. And is it about where we're building these homes? Because there's a need for housing and you want to build houses, but then you build them quickly and the materials, and it's expensive to build those miracle homes that did survive. And that just doesn't seem sustainable for people to be able to kind of use those materials. So what do we do?
Well, first off, in those materials, I agree that if you're uniquely going after some materials, but in other words, if we make a major change and those materials are mass produced, so you can get the costs down where that's not prohibitive to begin with. But there are the things you can do, of course, for your individual house, you know, putting in vents that are ember resistant and things of that sort to increase your odds. But just for the fire yesterday, when we were looking at that, and you looked at it from the aerials of it, and you see here are these canyons full of flammable vegetation, and then here's a ridge coming out here with houses along that ridge. There's a canyon wall on this side, a canyon wall on that side. Fire burns more rapidly, ferociously going up slopes. In other words, a lot of those houses are put into positions where their odds of surviving a fire are low.
So how do we change that, though? Because if they would say, okay, this is where we're going to build our homes, and we saw there's a KinderCare right up that hill that burned yesterday in Rancho Bernardo had places built right up on the hill. The apartments across from Fashion Valley Mall are literally built into that mountain that caught fire. Should they stop doing that, or should they take better care of it, or how does that work?
Well, again, these are things as a society we haven't really laid these out to discuss them in detail yet.
To me,
it means building with fire-resistant materials and designs, changing what looks good to us, you know, with nice overhangs and wooden patios coming out and things of that sort that are all flammable. We need to re-educate ourselves into having a house beauty as inflammability. Look, nowhere you can start a fire here.
That's true. It's a bigger issue than we can obviously figure out.
Much larger than what we're talking about today.
It's a societal thing at this point that we need to really address seriously. Pat Abbott, always a pleasure, sir.
Likewise.
Thank you.